In a previous episode, we learned how to measure the distance to the sun. Now, let's measure the distance to the stars. To begin, find the position of the star in the sky. Then wait 6 months and measure it again. The star will shift positions because we are viewing it from a different angle. Find the angle between these two positions and you can calculate the distance to the star. The problem is the nearest star is really, really, really far away, so it barely moves at all.
Behind me is our closest star, Alpha Centauri. How much does this little guy move? From the perspective of my camera, 5 feet away, he moves this much. 1/10 the width of a human hair. No wonder it took so long to discover this motion. No one detected any motion for thousands of years until Bessel did in 1838.
As you move away from the Earth, the motion of the stars just keeps getting smaller and smaller until you reach the limit of what telescopes can detect. It doesn't get us much further than our little corner of the galaxy. How do we locate the remaining stars? We use starlight.
Stars appear dim when they're far away from us. As they get closer, they get brighter.
The starlight radiates in all directions. The rays of light spread evenly over the surface of a sphere. The surface area increases by the square of the radius, so the star dims by that amount as you move away from it. The amount of light that a star gives off is called its luminosity. The amount of light that reaches the Earth gives us the apparent brightness. From the apparent brightness and the distance to the star, we can compute the luminosity.
Now, if we plot the luminosity and color of nearby stars, you will see a pattern that was first observed by Hertzsprung and Russell. Most stars appear along a band called the main sequence. We have bright blue stars here, yellow stars like our sun here, and then red dim stars. Most stars spend their life on the main sequence, then turn into giants, and then ultimately end up as white dwarfs.
This chart is important because we can use the color of a star to predict its luminosity. By comparing the predicted luminosity against the apparent brightness, we can estimate the distance to the star. This works well for clusters of stars because some stars are off the main sequence. By using the main sequence stars in the cluster, we can estimate the distance to star clusters throughout all the galaxy. For more astronomical videos, please click to subscribe.